Good evening, friends. I am Ravindra Srinivasa from Bangalore. I have with me Mistress M. Beena Emerson from Chengalpet near Chennai. She is a purpose coach and a lot more. Let us listen from her. I welcome Beena Emerson to the knowledge sharing program. Welcome, Beena.
Thank you. Thank you for having me here, Ravinder. And so to talk about me, I was raised in Mumbai. And after marriage, I shifted to Bangalore. And I got a flat here during the lockdown. And I shifted here because I found that my current house was a little, small for my growing family. So we shifted here. And I am a software developer by profession. I have been working in IT industry for almost 9 years now. But I am now a newly licensed purpose coach. To talk about the reason why I went down this path of being a purpose coach is that during lockdown, especially when 2020 came and everybody was locked at home, I realized I was going in a little bit of negative spiral. And then I started approaching different coaches and asking their help or their guidance. And I was lucky enough to meet quite a few of them. I have talked to at least three during 2020 and 2021. And they have been able to shed light on my patterns, on the way I'm thinking and how to improve it, how to manifest things in my life. You know, I have been reading books like Secret and all the other related books for a long time. I love reading books. I have a big collection of books. So I've been reading it and applying it. But then when I got the coach, I realized that between my application and the way they tell me, there's a wide gap. And when I interacted with them, I got that, quickness, like what I was applying, I was able to apply it in a larger scale and actually was able to manifest this house according to my liking because of my coach. So, and then once I got this house, I was like, okay, I've got everything that I need. And then I started feeling a bit of a void in me. It was like, what to do next? There was something that was kind of blocking me. And then I took a break from coaching. Like I told her that I would not like to continue for now. I just want to go within myself. So, and then I realized, I started helping my friends. And that's when I realized when they came back to me and they said, Beena, your tips worked for me. You know, now I'm able to do this. I realized, okay, I like doing this and I want to do this on a larger scale as a profession, so that's how I got in touch with the actual coaching course. And then I joined it and now I have got my license. So it was quite a lot of journey from 2020 March to here. It feels like I have gotten a long journey, though it doesn't seem like it's just been 2 years. And I have grown a lot. And I hope as a coach that I'm able to touch many lives like they have done for me. I'm able to do that for another group. So that is the reason I became a coach. So, okay. Yeah, I guess.
As a curiosity, I would like to know, which one is the licensing authority from where you got the license and may know who is your coach? I think they have trained you, they have coached you very excellently because I'm getting through your topics.
Oh, okay. Yeah. So my coach is from whom I got the coaching certificate is Nitesh Gavade and its company is Edify Labs. And that from there, I got this licensed purpose coach certificate. It's actually right behind me in red color. And I got it through that. And before meeting him, I had met Aarti Asrani and Thomas. So I had taken a couple of sessions with them as well. And then him. So yeah, these are my three main coaches that I had got in touch with.
Okay. Normally, for a common person to become a professional purpose coach, is there is any prerequisite qualification?
Well, you should be having that passion, having that reason, you know, to go and teach it to people. Like, you should have it within you. Because if you are like, normally, generally, if you go to see, everybody is a coach. Anybody comes to you, don't you give advice? Anybody. Friends come to you.
To give advice, we should have the knowledge and we should have the experience and expertise in the subject. That is what I believe.
That makes you professional. But you tell me, anybody comes to you, you would go and give them, right? You shouldn't maybe not do it like this. Maybe try this.
Okay, whatever we know, we will give whatever, exactly. Whatever we know. Yeah.
Yes, you give it from your knowledge. And everybody does that. Right, but not everybody wants to do it on a larger scale. They are okay with helping their friends, their family members. You know, some people just read books a lot, like I used to do. And it's not that I've never advised my friends before, right? I have helped them. And they are like always, you know, you are a jovial person, you know, you listen a lot, like, you know, without judgment. I have been doing that for so long. People come and tell me stuff and they know it doesn't go out of from here. I don't share it with anybody else. So it is like they have been doing that and I have been kind of suggesting something for them. But then, you know, when you yourself go through that journey of being coached by a coach and then you are becoming a coach, the way you talk, way you know, do those very same things becomes different, right? Mm. You pay, anybody will play cricket, right? Yeah. You must have also played when you were a small kid.
Yes.
Everybody has played cricket. But then what's the difference between you and everybody who plays it professionally?
Now also there's I'm playing cricket, Beena.
Sorry?
Yeah. Also you are playing cricket.
You are not playing cricket.
Not when I'm a small kid.
Yeah. So now also you're playing cricket. That's great. That's great. But there's a difference, right? In how you play and how, you know, say Sachin Tendulkar
used
to play, or, you know, everybody, Virat
Kohli.
Rahul
Dravid plays. Yeah.
Yeah. So there's so much difference, right? Why is there a difference? Because they have been specifically trained in that.
Yes.
Right. Yeah, and they want to do it. They have that desire to play on a national level and all. So they have done it. They've gone through that path. They have done it.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
So locally, maybe you're like the best cricketer in town, you know. But then nationally, maybe you will not fare so well. So then I have been trained to be a coach, now I know, you know, how I can talk to people, how I can get them to the conclusion that they want. To see things in a different way. So it's like, it's kind of an inbuilt thing in us. But then when you are trained, you become much better. You become, you know, that kind of you get streamlined in the way you talk, the way you interact with people. It kind of differs. The way I'm talking to my friends now when they come to me with an issue and the way I used to do it, say, a couple of months back, it is different. Right. Now I also know much better. I know things deeper. So, you know, it's easier for me to sometimes identify when people start ranting. I'm able to identify the patterns much quicker. And, you know, it kind of shifts. So, yeah. So when you are trained to be a coach, the way you see things, the way you interact, everything changes. Yeah.
So, normally, how long it will take to become a coach?
Right now, my certification took 9 weeks.
Okay.
So first, yeah. So now my actual coaching, it has, they have given us a framework. First, we have gone through that framework, you know, ourselves as a student, we have worked on that framework. Okay. And then now we are trained to take that framework and use it on people, teach it to people, educate people using that framework. And now I also have got a lot of course content which I can go through. And now I can create my own courses, like based on that framework or something on my own. So it is a learning process. So first, right now, I can do one course and then now I will be learning more and more. And like I've got access to their entire session. So now I'll be learning more about it and then create my own thing. So they have got sessions for that as well. So yeah, so I have got it. I can start coaching, but yeah, I can still grow, right? Every time you learn something new, you grow. Yeah.
Is there is any next step like that? I mean, first level, second level, third level like that?
No, right now in this certificate, you have got the certificate, that's it. And then you become a coach and you can do whatever you can, make it either to your client type whom you want to be more involved with. And or you can do some specialization, whatever you want, you can do it. You can use the framework, same framework, and add those specializations in that. Oh. And but there is also an ICF certification. I am not sure of the full form, but it's an international certification. They have got 3 levels of a coaching certificate. And yeah, so I know of them. I am not aware of any other professional certificates, but yeah. Okay. So you have got that as well. I know that levels, it's associate coaching certificate, professional coaching certificate, and mastery coaching certificate. These are the 3 levels in that.
Who conducts? And
it's not necessary for me to do that certification.
Okay.
I can do it if I want, but right now I can.
Okay.
Yes.
With what you have, you can give a lot of wonders. You can develop it. You can grow. Yes. You can yourself can go to the next level. The more you interaction with the people, the more knowledge you will get.
Definitely, yeah.
Right? The more clients you will get, the more case history, case study you will get.
Right.
So the more people got the advantage, the more confidence level will build within you. Because
definitely.
Your confidence will go because you have solved so many cases. You have supported people and people got benefited out of your tips and coaching, right?
Right.
Okay. Now, I would like to know what is a purpose coach and how it is useful to the public? Is it useful only to certain set of people, or it can be utilized from all sections of people? How it is useful to students, working people, even housewives, senior citizens? Okay, yeah. lot of category of people we have. So,
yes.
Is it applicable? If yes, to whom and how?
Okay, so it is applicable to everybody. Okay. Now, when we say purpose coaching, what we mean actually is that we find out who you are. Okay. Your core values, what are your passions? What is your potential, natural potential? And then, based on that, we help you align with your goals. Okay. Generally, people have that, finding a purpose means breaking your current lifestyle and doing something entirely different. Right. That's what happens when I say purpose coaching. Is that what you do? It's like, no, it's not just that. Like if that is a requirement for you, like based on who you are, what you are doing currently does not match with who you are, then yes, maybe you will have to change career, do something different. But then those who are already on a path, on a career path that they like, they love doing, but sometimes they find a dissatisfaction, inner contentment is not there, inner peace is not there. Maybe that is because, as a person, you have got different aspects. Right. You like, I am an IT developer, so logic is good for me. And I chose that because when I took that career assessment, for me, it was decided that your logic is very good. And then you can, it is better for you to choose this. And I'm doing that. But then when I did this course, I realized there are I like visual, spatial, my order, all these things are also part of me, part of who I am. And not implementing all those things in my life is what is making me a little restless, you know. So now for me, order. So order is like, I need to know, have a correct guideline, correct path, everything. So now I keep a book. Whatever steps I do, I just write it there, you know, so that I know, okay, I've tried all this. I've got a written way. And visual spatial, yeah. So I have tried to create a vision board in front of me, you know, so that kind of inspires me. These are all tips you will say, people tell you everywhere, but then how much does it apply to you, right? Maybe doing this vision board does not work for everybody. They are not maybe inspired by that. For them, it's something else, maybe just writing, you know. So each person is unique, each person is different, they have got different aspects of them. So when you make small changes, some person is very close to nature, they have that inner feeling, you know, to be close to nature. For them, it is better that they do gardening, at least in their house, so that they will feel that peace, right? Maybe it does not apply to everybody. Like, I don't have a green thumb. I try to do it, but I guess I'm still working on it. Okay. So it is like that, you know, each person is different. So finding out who you are, changing smaller things in your life itself will make you be happy, content, you know, doing what you're doing. You will do it better. Once we have that inner peace, inner contentment, you will do what you're doing better on a bigger scale. Right. So that is what it is. Purpose, when I say purpose coaching, is coaching depending on who you are. Okay, depending on your values.
Who am I?
Mm-hmm.
Will be decided by purpose coach?
We have a set of assessments.
Okay.
So, yeah, we have a set of assessments which will give you some results, and we will take pointers from that, and then we will ask you to practice it, and depending on which actions you sync with, then we'll say, okay, see, this works for you. So next time when you come with some trouble, you're like, oh, this, I'm not feeling very good about this, then we sit with your values and then we see which particular value is not matching or not being applied here. Okay. And then we will discuss, do we really need to apply this value here? Because not everything can be applied in every section of your life.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So then you will decide, okay, then you will be like, okay, here I cannot apply this. Okay, I can apply it to this level. You know, for me, I used to post in Instagram even before I joined coaching. Okay. But then there was like something missing for me. I did not realize what it was. Well, after I did this, I sat with my values. I realized that there's no order in my post. Like, I post, when I do a certain post, I make it as pleasing as possible, post it. But then when you look at my page, it is all random. There was no discipline in it. So now I have changed my style. So I've used a theme, and now I feel a little more satisfied with my Instagram page. So though I know I like order before, I did not apply it to my Instagram page. Mm-hmm. So now I was like, okay, let's try this. So now I'm feeling a bit more calm. So, you know, these are the finer points, like you will have to see. Sometimes you cannot apply it. Sometimes you will have to let go, right? And then sometimes if you can, you can apply it. Then that makes you feel a little more peaceful. So that is what is actually purpose coaching. And it starts here, and then it will take you to places where you did not even think is possible. Right? Once you start being who you are, happy being who you are, you don't know where you will go. You can simply fly. So yeah, this is a beginning. And I think it is clear from what I've explained that this is applicable for everybody. Finding out who you are is needed, because only then you will be able to apply things according to who you are.
So in purpose coach, any person is able to know who he or she, right?
Yes.
And whatever
assessment, yeah, we have the assessment. So if you are honest in that assessment, it will give you an honest reply. If you are going to try to fake it and trying to, you know, give an output which is you think is the best, then it does not solve the purpose.
Okay. Normally, suppose, let us assume, mm-hmm. one person has approached you, he or she, mm-hmm. to take a coach from you on to find out what is our what is his or her potential, and whatever their existing level, whatever they are doing, business or working, or even housewives or retired people or senior citizens for that matter, they want to know who they are and what is the purpose of them. Normally, how long it will take?
The current framework
to conclusion level.
Yeah, no. Current framework that we have, it's called Discover My Core, and it takes minimum of 6 weeks.
1.5 months.
Yes.
So they are supposed to have regular touch with you, with the coach, or how it is?
It is a weekly session.
Okay.
And we will be available for support on phone in between sessions. And it is like 1 hour to 1.5 hour session per week.
Okay.
And like we go through different explanations, the way your brain works. And then we find out who you are, and then we help you apply your values in your life, you know. Mm. And then once this is done, you can continue the personal coaching for your specific issue or what you want to do, you know. So it could be an ongoing process, but if you do a 6 week course, you will get your blueprint, like you will get your values, and then a way going forward, how can you apply these for your personal life, you know, for your goals, and you can see whether that goal aligns with your aligns with who you are, and then you can take a decision, you know. So once you do this 6 weeks course, you would basically be in a position to handle future goals, you know, ongoing, how you can do it. But then you can choose to continue coaching as well if you feel that, okay, I need guidance in some aspect. This, I'm making a new change. I need more guidance. So yes, you can continue that aspect.
Okay. This purpose coach, once it is chosen after 6 weeks, something is getting concluded. See, this is what your core area, and this is what is your potential, and this is what you are really inclined to do.
Right.
All those things will be decided.
Right.
After some time, is there is any chance it will get deviated?
It will get deviated in the sense your as you grow, maybe your values have changed a bit. Then there is a process which you can do again. Like, you may not even require a coach for that. We will give it to you, and you can do that process again, but it will take a couple of years, because once you get to a different level, you know, you could say that, okay, right now I have achieved this much. Maybe my goal right now is something else. You know, I need to achieve this, you know, maybe more community service. So then a little bit, it will not even drastically change, but maybe some points may change.
Yeah, some time back I heard one beautiful sentence in English.
Mm-hmm.
Just it recalled in my memory. When you change, you will grow. Mm. And when you grow, you will change.
Definitely.
So as and when a people keep changing, they will be keep growing. And when they keep growing, again, their priorities will get changed.
Right.
So it keeps on changing the values, the priorities, the goals. They may set a new goal. They may choose another field. They may. So that is
definitely
one, right?
Yeah. You are not the same person who you were many years before Corona. No, don't even go many years back. Before Corona. The person you are right now, isn't it different from who you were before Corona, before 2020. Right.
Yes.
Yeah. So if we had done this process, maybe, you know, this, if you had taken the course back then, maybe you would have different values. Right now, if you do it, maybe a couple of them have changed. One or two might have changed. Now you want this more, you know. So
as
a person changes, they grow and they change. Change is part of life. You cannot deny it. You cannot remain constant at all. So it is part of life. And what
change is inevitable. Nobody can stop the change.
Nobody can. And even I'm not telling that once this is done, this is what you have to follow. Like, well, you can start applying, and then after 1 year or something, you are like, okay, now right now I feel okay, I have completely applied this, I don't sync with it anymore. Then you can, you know, do that checking again, and then maybe have a new value. It will definitely not be entirely different, but certain points of it could be a little, you know, next level maybe.
So I think it is a continuing evaluation process.
Definitely.
Correct?
Yes.
And as a purpose coach, you will be along with your client and supporting the client whenever there is a requirement, whenever there is support is needed.
Yeah, definitely. If anybody approaches us, we would be glad to help them. We will, and since we, if they have gone through this program and we have got their code list, then it will be easier for us to suggest them, because now we know what they like, what they are, who they are actually. So which suggestion was better applied for them. And if they are, you know, sometimes taking that new step is scary. Okay, so then we will give them a push saying that this is who you are. You need this for yourself, and then they can do it, you know. So that is what it is. And
okay.
And
normally, normally if any new clients comes to you or to any purpose coach, the complete guidance, support, analysis will be done by the same purpose coach, or it will be like as a study case, it will be studied by all the purpose coaches cumulative suggestions or anything is there?
No, I don't think we do that. But suppose if I get into a problem and even I need suggestion, I feel okay, this seems to be confusing, maybe I can ask some help.
Okay.
But no, we don't sit together and, you know, do it in person.
Group of purpose coach will not take as a case study.
No.
Okay.
No. And I don't think they might. I think we would go back to our coaches when we are planning to launch a new program, and we need some guidance. You know, since he has got experience, we might talk to him and we might ask for suggestions there. I think otherwise, if a client comes to us, I feel we purpose coaches are equipped enough to help them, guide them, you know, because who you are, once you know who you are, you would know how to apply it. In fact, you don't even need us to tell you,
okay,
this is what you have to do. We can just simply say, see, this is what it is, you know, just nudge you there, just kind of point you there, and you will be like, oh, this is it. And it will be a self-realization.
Okay.
Yeah.
Very nice talking to you, Beena ji. And we will have our session to continue. And I request all the viewers to interact with Beena, and let Beena support the world with her knowledge and experience.
Thank you, Ravindra. It was a great session. I loved chatting with you, and you had really good questions for me.
Thank you.
And I look forward to helping anybody who wants to seek me. My details will be provided by Ravindra in the description box.
Yes.
Thank you.
And we look forward a lot of knowledge flow into the global.
Yes.
Thank you for being with us.
Thank you.